Kasit Piramya, once again. We all must have been noticing that the past few weeks, the Thai Prime Minister, General Prayut Chan Ocha, had been very, very busy with international political and economic activities, bilateral, regional, and multilateral. And two important ones were the recently held ASEAN Summit meeting, the 48th ASEAN Summit meeting in Phnom Penh, the capital city of Cambodia, where Cambodia under Prime Minister Somdet Hun Sen was the chair of ASEAN. And General Prayut Chan Ocha, as leader of Thailand, had participated in the various meetings of ASEAN pertaining to political activities, security, economic, social, and cultural activities, and so on. Then a few days later, General Prayut Chan Ocha from the, 17 to the 19th of November, he had to chair the APEC summit meeting, the 29th APEC summit meeting. APEC is the abbreviation for the Asia-Pacific Economic Cooperation, which was, initiated by Australia in 1989. As a result, one of the result of the financial crisis of Thailand, the global changes, the end of the Cold War. So the whole world had to adjust and have to find way of working among themselves internationally and regionally. And I think the Pacific Ocean had so many important riparian states on both sides of the ocean. On one hand, North America and South American country on the eastern side, and on the western side, China, Japan, South Korea, Taiwan, Australia, members of the ASEAN community down to Australia, New Zealand, and so on. So these are important political and economic powers of the world, particularly China and the United States, and to a lesser extent, the Russian Federation, and of course, Japan and South Korea. And in all of this, General Prayut Chan Ocha was participating in various meetings. He has heard so many things. He has learned many things. He has been reminded of the commitments that ASEAN has to the regional organization or to the ASEAN organization and so on. He must have learned a lot of things about the vision and the course of direction of the various countries from other leaders and so on, which more or less have been, meeting the same challenges like COVID-19, climate change, the breakup in the global supply chain, the problem within the globalization economic world, and so on. So, and since all of these meeting had already passed by the end of November, then the question, or the question to be asked to General Prayut is that now you will have time to attend to the affairs of Thailand. And what you have learned in Phnom Penh or in Bangkok during the APEC meeting, or you have learned something from the result of the meeting in Bali of the group of 20, what are you going to do with Thailand from what you have learned, from what you have heard, and so on? How are you going to improve the situation in Thailand? So in other words, General Prayut Chan Ocha must turn his attention now from international political economic things to the domestic ones, because there are many challenges waiting for him in Thailand. And there will not be any more important meetings, for the next few weeks, few months to come. General Prayut Chan Ocha will have all the time to attend to the domestic affairs. But to do that, he must also, there is a need for him to clear himself of where he is at the moment in the Thai political arena. Because it could be recalled that according to the ruling of the Constitutional Court, General Prayut Chan Ocha can remain as the Thai Prime Minister only for the next 2 years to complete the 8-year term limit for any Thai citizen to become a Prime Minister of Thailand. But there have been questions whether he is going to dissolve the parliament, call for the new elections, will he going to resign because he doesn't want to go on until the 8-year limit in the 2 years time to pave the way for the new leaders to come up and so on. And then also to, I think, allow the time for political parties to repositioning himself and so on without the presence of General Prayut. But if he were to continue, he must be able to tell the people so that gossips and rumors will not be the name of the game. And if he wants to be the Prime Minister beyond the 8-year period, what would be his ideas and to change the rules and so on? And why does he want to go for a longer period, like a Prime Minister for the lifetime, emulating, I think, the current Chinese leader, President Xi Jinping, that would like to continue the leadership of China for life? If General Prayut would like to do so, there is no inhibition. But he must be able to explain everything to the people. It would be better to be clear, straightforward to the people, and do not leave any doubts or some of the stone covered and so on. You know, because the once we do have the clarity and the assurance of from the Prime Minister, it will have a very positive bearing on the Thai political arena. It will settle down a bit. Everyone will know what to do, how to play the political game, how to adjust oneself or to the realignment of all the political party and forces in the country. But there is a need for General Prayut Chan Ocha to be clear and firm as to his political ambition. I think this is something that he owns to the Thai people. He needs to be clear in order to give the certainty and the stability to the Thai political arena. So in that sense, we have the right to ask this question and to get the answer from General Prayut Chan Ocha, what he is going to do with himself in the Thai political scene for the next 2 years. And does he have any idea or agenda for the next 10 years or 5 years and so on? That would be helpful to the people at large and for the lining up of all the political parties and forces and personality in the Thai political arena. So let's ask General Prayut, tell us, what do you want to do? ขอบคุณมากครับ. Thank you.